take it on.
Yes, it's so nice to have somebody managing the technology. Oh, technology. That's why I retired. Oh. I understand never, and I understand always.
Yes.
It's the sometimes I don't understand. It worked yesterday.
Yes.
Why doesn't it work today? Oh, dear.
Good morning.
Yeah.
Welcome to St. Mark's this morning. So glad you're here to give thanks to God and to pray for this world. We are thrilled to have our bishop with us to celebrate the feast day of St. Mark, which actually happens this coming week, but we've transferred it for today so that we can all celebrate together. That's why there's so much red. And if you are unable to find anything red for today, don't worry. There's another red day coming in a couple weeks called Pentecost, where we can wear red again. Just a few announcements before we begin our service. Just one announcement. We want to acknowledge that the flowers that are so beautifully placed at the front are given by Brenda Horner and Ron Hens in memory for the life and love of Brenda's father, Jeff Horner. We give thanks to God for Jeff. And now, as we prepare our hearts for worship, let us recall that God is love, and perfect love drives away fear. So would you pray with me by taking a deep breath and breathing in God's love and breathing out all of the cares and concerns that you have brought into this place? A second time, would you breathe in the love of God and breathe out? And on behalf of this world, which is finding it so difficult to breathe these days, on their behalf, would you breathe in once again God's love and breathe out? Our opening hymn is number 3, Morning Has Broken. Would you stand as you are able?
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
May his grace and peace be with you. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to pray the words of the collect for today with me. Let us pray. Almighty God, by the hand of Mark, the evangelist, you gave to your church the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. We thank you for his witness and pray that we may be grounded firmly in its truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
I'd like to invite all those who are going to Sunday school to come and meet the bishop, more especially this morning. Good to see you. It is good to be at church. Do you know why it's good to be at church? It's good to be at church so that we can say thank you to God, right? Can you say thank you?
Thank you.
I wonder what kind of things you want to say thanks for.
Life.
The opportunity to be confirmed soon.
The opportunity to be confirmed soon.
Great.
Your parents.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Love.
Love. That we have a right to an education. Yes.
Oh, great.
Family. Oh, there's so much.
And friends.
Friends.
So we can live.
So we can live. Exactly. Can we say again, thank you?
Thank you.
Thank you.
And the other reason we come to church is to ask God for help and pray for this world, right? There's lots of things that we might ask God for help for. We won't get into all of them today. But if you have a question that you want to ask God for help with, you make sure you share it with your parents, with me, with the bishop, with Sarah. So, this is Bishop John. Can you say hi, Bishop John?
Hi.
Yeah. Bishop John is my boss.
I am.
So you can tell him everything. That is okay. All right. That's right. So we are so glad that Bishop John is here today, because he's going to share with us the food that Jesus gave him to share with us. And that food is the body and blood of Christ. And we're going to receive a blessing at the end of the church. I know I'm putting you on the spot a bit.
Sure.
What should we do when you give us a blessing?
Right. Well, that's a great question. So basically, you can just sit and receive it, or stand. Probably we're standing at that point, and receive it. Some people do like to make the sign of the cross when they receive that. Feel free to do that. If that feels comfortable to you, you're welcome to do that. It's very simple. Just if you start somewhere near your forehead, come down to somewhere around your belly, and then up to your left shoulder, to your right shoulder. But if it looks a little bit different, or if it's not something you're comfortable doing, it is okay. God's blessing still arrives upon us, even if we haven't made the sign of the cross. But many, many like to do that.
Thank you. And Bishop John, again, putting you on the spot.
Okay, it's all right.
Why are you wearing a funny hat?
I know. Yeah. So this is called, does anybody know what it's called? Ah, we do. Somebody does know. A mitre. This is called a mitre. And it's supposed to look a bit like, you can see the flame here. It's supposed to, does it look a bit like a flame? A little bit, if you sort of kind of blur your eyes, or maybe close your eyes, maybe. that's the intention. And why on earth would I want to wear something that looks a bit like a flame on my head? It starts to get pretty warm here. Yeah?
Because God's light.
Because of God's light. Wow, that is a brilliant answer. Because of God's light, if you didn't hear that. That's right. And it's also a reminder of the Holy Spirit bringing light and fire to the first church, to this church, to every church. So that's why I remind it, aware. It's like a reminder of God's light, of the Holy Spirit in our midst.
And now one more question, because you also came in with another funny thing.
Right.
Why do you have a funny stick?
Right. So did anybody see? Maybe, yeah, David can.
Yes.
So you know what the shape, what does it remind you of anything? Wow, that's right. With the person who had the sheep, a shepherd. There you go, thanks. There we are. That's what it looks like. Right. So that actually is the intention, is that it looks like something that a shepherd might hold.
It looks like a P.
Looks like the letter P. It does a bit, doesn't it? You're right. Yeah. Yeah. And it. So maybe I should work on this and make it a little bit more that it looks like a shepherd's crook. Yeah? Can you feel it? Yes, you can even hold it. Wow. If you keep holding it for long enough, we'll start calling you bishop, too.
And you'll be my boss.
That's right. That's right. So, and it's a sign that a bishop is like a shepherd, and is asked to care for all of the churches. And David was describing me as his boss, but it's also that shepherding role of encouraging and helping and supporting as well. So sometimes those shepherds have to make some difficult decisions to try and help out the sheep and to keep that sort of image going. Yeah, and that's part of the role. Yeah, so
thank
there we go.
You,
thank
Mr.
you.
John,
yeah. No, it's so great to be with all of you. Thank you. Thanks for the great comments and thoughts.
Well, this is a repeat after me prayer.
This is a repeat after me prayer.
Loving God.
Loving God.
You are amazing.
You are amazing.
Shine a light in our hearts.
Shine a light in our hearts.
So we can know you more and more.
So we can know you more and more.
And show us Jesus.
And show us Jesus.
Our friend and helper.
Our friend and helper.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, we'll see you at communion.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy. For in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth together into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. Listen for God's word.
Our hearts are open.
Please join me as we pray the Psalm 2 responsively. Let me announce the decree of the Lord, who said to me, you are my heir. This day have I begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall crush them with an iron rod, and shatter them like a piece of pottery. And now, you monarchs, be wise. Be warned, you rulers of the earth. Submit to the Lord with fear, and bow with trembling before the presence of the Lord, lest God be angry and you perish. For the divine wrath is quickly kindled. Happy are they all who take refuge in God.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Ephesians. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery or their craftiness in deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body joined and knitted together by every ligament with which it is equipped. As each part is working properly, it promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. Listen for God's word.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. In the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written by the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight.'" John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove upon him. And the voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness for 40 days, tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I speak to you in the name of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Amen.
Amen.
I invite you to please be seated. Well, I am delighted to be with you here at St. Mark's, especially on this gorgeous morning. What a beautiful day for a drive out to Ocean Park. It's always sunny in Ocean Park, I'm sure. The last time I was here was for the induction of your rector, David. And that was such a great celebration, and what a beautiful evening it was. So it's good to be back today to continue, really, that celebration as we focus on the saint after whom this parish was named. So thank you for the ministry of this parish, for the many ways that you connect with the surrounding community. I am also so grateful for your priest, for David, for the great work that he's doing here in the parish, but as you're probably well aware, also in many different parts of the diocese and beyond that. David is gifted in so many ways, and I know that I don't need to tell you that, but I am so appreciative of the ways that he shares that in this diocese and in our ecclesiastical province. It's good to be with all of you. There's a lot of energy being put into discovering more about who we are these days. There are people, and maybe there are some folks here, but I certainly know quite a number who have sent off a DNA sample with hopes of learning more about their background and where in the world they might have come from. More about their roots, their genetic background, their family's migratory history. And there are, of course, a variety of popular websites that have all sorts of tools to help individuals discover more about their family tree and potential links to royalty or rock stars or train robbers. I'm sure that you've probably seen this too. But you can potentially get pictures or images or more details of birth records that can help paint a picture of who you are, at least historically, maybe racially. Roughly a year ago, I spent about a week in Ireland where I've got quite a lot of family. And I met up with aunts and uncles and cousins and second cousins and third cousins twice removed. It was all really lovely. On one particular day, I officiated at worship at the church where my family has been worshiping for well over 100 years. Yeah, sorry to tell you, but there are people a bit like me in other parts of the globe. And coming out of the church to greet folks after worship, I turned to see the grave of my grandparents and their parents and my uncle and several others. That feeling of stepping on the same ground, praying in the same church, and touching the same door handles as those connected to me but from long ago felt quite grounding and affirming and comforting. Comforting in knowing a little bit more about where I had come from and my roots. For none of us exist in a complete vacuum, but are affected and linked to an extension of family, past and present. We're linked to some of their actions and decisions and even their perspectives. And we can see God working in all of that. For these connections shape all of us. The reading from Mark's Gospel that we heard just a moment ago, read by Martha, was all about this. It was a reminder of our family history, our Christian story, our deep rootedness and grounding in the coming of Jesus into this world to transform us by grace. And for us here at St. Mark's, maybe this is even more poignant to hear on this day as we celebrate St. Mark himself. The beginning of Mark's Gospel is quite different than the other three Gospels in our Bible. There is no birth narrative, for one thing. This Gospel book simply gets on with it, gets to the heart, gets to the DNA, if you will, of us Christians, and invites us right into the scene. It invites us into a deeper relationship with Jesus in how we walk in this world focused on our roots, our background, our narrative. It names where we have come from and how it connects with where we sit even now. The Gospel of Mark, as you just heard, started actually not with Jesus, but with John the Baptizer, the one who invites us to make way, the one called to be a messenger, a voice crying in the wilderness, calling people to repent and receive forgiveness of their sins. But he knew his job. It was not to be louder and more visible than Jesus. No, his was to be the humble preparer, and his role was to step very much then to the sidelines. He knew that he was not able to untie the laces of Jesus' shoes, and that he only baptized with water. But with Jesus, it would be different. In the Message, a version of the Bible that takes some liberties while putting the words in more contemporary language, the author Eugene Peterson writes it this way. John the Baptizer appeared in the wild, preaching a baptism of life change that leads to forgiveness of sins. People thronged to him from Judea and Jerusalem, and they confessed their sins, were baptized by him in the River Jordan into a changed life. As he preached, he said, "The real action comes next. The star in this drama, to whom I'm a mere stagehand, will change your life. I'm baptizing you here in the river, turning your old life in for a kingdom life. His baptism, a holy baptism by the Holy Spirit, will change you from the inside out." Will change you from the inside out. These are our relatives speaking, and their words still apply. We continue to seek this kind of baptism, this kind of change, this kind of arrival of the Holy Spirit, so that indeed we turn our old life in for a kingdom life, a life where the Holy Spirit changes us from the inside out. Jesus was then baptized by John in the river, making the start of all that was to come. In Mark's gospel, just like our own lives, baptism was central and key and the sign of the beginning. And a voice was heard saying words that we too need to treasure. "You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased." Those words were echoed at our baptism as well. For we too are seen as beloved of God. As our relationship with God was marked with this same baptismal beginning, grafting us into Christ's family, and all part of changing us from the inside out. If you remember, Jesus is then whisked off to the wilderness for some 40 days. Once again, Mark doesn't get into any real details of this time of temptation, and he seems keen to simply get to the key statement which is about to be delivered by Jesus, a central statement to the people of that time and our time, a statement aimed directly at this parish church and at each one of us individually. We heard Jesus say, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." This is our story. This is our family history. This is our connection and our invitation with these words from Jesus. The kingdom of God has come near. The same is true this morning. For this kingdom is known here, changing us from the inside out. Today we are celebrating and honoring St. Mark's Day. Mark is most often remembered because of his authorship of this gospel book. But his story did not begin or end there. It's understood that after the resurrection and the day of Pentecost and the ascension, Mark made his way to Alexandria to become a bishop and to spread the gospel of Jesus, inviting people to be changed from the inside out. It's said that after he died, a relic of his bones made its way to Venice in Italy. And if you've ever been to Venice, chances are that after you've got over the excitement of seeing the canals and the gondoliers and the shops of all kinds and many other sights and sounds, once you have seen all of this, chances are pretty good that you will make your way to St. Mark's Square. When you walk into the square, it fills all of your senses with beauty and smells and tastes and extraordinary wonder. You'll see a beautiful statue of a lion representing Mark the Evangelist, once more inviting you into his story that he's wanting to tell. And on the edge of this exquisite square is the basilica in which those same relics of Mark are said to lie in rest, continuing to link the past with the present, our family roots with Mark and John and Jesus. If you send off your DNA sample, you might just discover that by your baptism, you are part of this family. For you have heard and seen that the kingdom of God has indeed come near, and indeed is known here amongst us even now. We have known those words of repent as well, and turn to the way of Jesus, the way of love, the way of the kingdom, the way of peace, the way of new life. For we believe in the good news, and we know that it is indeed good news that continues to invite us to be changed from the inside out. This church has been called to do that, as have all of us who have been baptized like Jesus with water and the Holy Spirit. For that marked the beginning of our own journey of faith, linking us with our family tree of faith, with the communion of saints, past and present, beckoning us to come closer and to live into Christ's way. In the reading from the letter to the Ephesians, it was phrased this way, "But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ." May it be so, from the inside out. Amen. If you are able, I invite you to please stand. Let us confess our faith as we say, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven, who by the power of the Holy Spirit became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made human, who for our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate, who suffered death and was buried, who on the third day rose again in accordance with the Scriptures, who ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and whose kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray, responding, "Hear our prayer to Lord our Shepherd." Lord our Shepherd, thank you. Let us pray, responding, "Hear our prayer to Lord our Shepherd. Lord our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for our clergy and people across the diocese of the New Westminster, the ministries of our diocese, and of our ministries in St. Mark's. We pray for the Anglican Church of Canada, for our companion, the Episcopal Diocese of the Northern Philippines, and the Overseas Missionary Fellowship of Taiwan. Lord, our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all in positions of power, that you guide them to your ways of truth, that they may do good in this world through you. Lord, our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for places in the world in a state of turmoil, such as the Congo, Gambia, Yemen, Ukraine, Palestine, Sudan, Ethiopia, Taiwan, and Myanmar. Lord, our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for people suffering in need of your loving hand to hold as they climb their mountain. Lord, our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for your servants, Smokey Collins, Beryl Dawson, Richard, and John Johnson, that have passed on this week to you, and that their loved ones find community and comfort. Lord, our Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for those in need of prayer this week, that you lift them up. Nancy, John Goram, and Karen Wayne, Gary, Sue, Mike, Shane, and Stephen, Allison, Massa, Kai, and Emmy, Ross, Jared and Curtis, Stephen Z, the Dawson family, Lynn, Ian, Christine, Ruth, Tim, Angela and Jenna. Doug. Brooke and Steve. Bibi and family. Pat. Joyce. Turney. Judy. Sophia, Lily, Zach, Milo, Layton, and Nathan. Lord, our shepherd.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for those in our hearts, either aloud or silently. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus Christ, the Lord, the Redeemer of sins. St. Mark the Evangelist, our patron saint. And we are thankful for you, God, our shepherd, for patiently and mercifully guiding your sheep. Amen.
Amen. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. God welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I invite you to please stand as you are able. And may the peace of the Lord be always with you. Peace to you. Peace be with you. Let's peace be with you. Nice to see you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Let's peace be with you. Nice to see you this morning. God's peace be with you. No, no, it's all good.
I was so excited.
It's so great.
I have to tell you.
Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Peace. Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Peace to you. God's peace be with you. Peace. God's peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Nice to see you. God's peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace.
bruised and wounded him. It was our sin that brought him down. When we like sheep had gone astray, our shepherd came and on his shoulders bore our shame. Our God reigns, our God reigns, our God reigns, our God reigns. As a lamb that's led out to the slaughterhouse, come as a sheep before its shearer. His life ran down upon the ground like pouring rain.
God of our salvation, accept all we offer you this day. May we learn to bear witness to the gospel of your Son, both in word and deed. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and
blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, because in the fellowship of your saints, you have given us a glorious pledge of the hope of our calling. Therefore, we join our voices with theirs as earth and heaven unite to proclaim the glory of your name. Thanks to you, Lord, our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your children. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. As our Savior taught us, let us sing. We died with you on the cross. Now we are raised to new life. We were buried in your tomb. Now we share in your resurrection. Live in us that we may live in you. These are the gifts of God for the children of God.
Thanks be to God.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. Oh, I'm sorry. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. May God's love and mercy be upon you this day and forevermore. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. This is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you.
I will raise you up on the last.
I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection, I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God. I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
Gracious God, may the gifts we have received at your table strengthen us in the faith of the gospel preached by Mark. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for our announcements.
Thank you. I think there are a few announcements this morning. Sarah is coming. Pat, you have something important to share as well. To note that this Saturday at Christ Church Cathedral, seven of our dear ones are going to be confirmed by Bishop John. So if you're able to come, the service is at 10:30. Do come and give them your support. We will have cake on the Sunday following. So next Sunday, if you can't make it to the cathedral, make it here in the morning for that. And please take note of all of the announcements that are written in your bulletin. There's some important things coming up that we even need your help with. But Pat has some good news, I think, to share with us this morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Many of you know me. My name is Pat Aiken. My wife Janet and I together are coordinators for the refugee sponsorship program here at St. Mark's. Others have joined us also, so we're not the only two, by all means. 14 months ago, this congregation voted unanimously to sponsor a family from Afghanistan. The good news I have to share with you this morning is that they are on their way. They'll be landing in Vancouver on this coming Tuesday, the 23rd of April, at 4:30 in the afternoon. This will change their lives forever. This congregation has responded magnificently to this project. When we asked for beds, we got beds. When we asked for dressers, we got dressers. When we asked for tables, chairs, knives, forks, spoons, plates, cups, saucers, we got it all. It's all here waiting for them to be put into an apartment for them. Unfortunately, that's one thing we haven't quite got a hold of yet. We're still looking for some long-term accommodation for them. We'll find it, but it's been a long struggle to go through this process and to get here, and we're just absolutely excited that it's going to happen soon, and we'll welcome them here. I just want to thank all of you for your financial support, for your physical support, and for all of those things that were gathered to give to this young family. I thank you very much.
My goodness, what great news to follow. Good morning, everyone. I would just like to remind all our families that we have our next Messy Church happening on May 25th. So please come for story, song, and prayer and a lively Eucharist with our Reverend David and enjoy a meal together. It's from 4 till 6. As David said, we will be celebrating our confirmation youth on Sunday next week. There will be refreshments, and there will be a very special presentation for each of our youth on that Sunday morning. So please come and love on our youth. Thank you so very much.
The only other news is that following the service, we have a potluck. So please stay and eat all of the food that is being prepared right now in the hall. We're going to count this service as grace. So once you exit here and go into the hall, just get in line and fill your bellies. And then we're thrilled to have the bishop with us who's going to lead us in a conversation. If you're able to stay after you are full, please come and ask the bishop all the questions you want. And the bishop will share with us some of the things that are on his heart as well.
Great. Thank you. Wonderful. Wow, what great news. So wonderful to hear about refugees, especially when you know they're coming, because it's often a long time waiting. So really delighted, and I know it's still a lot of work to support them now, but wonderful, wonderful news. And also really looking forward to confirmation next Saturday. I'm really excited about it, and it was great to meet many of the young folk from here last Saturday. And so really look forward to, if you're able to come, encourage you to come to the cathedral and share in the day with them. I invite you to please stand as you are able. As we pray together, glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. May God, the Creator, the giver of your daily bread, give you peace. May Jesus Christ, who came to live amongst us, who died and rose again, give you peace. May the Holy Spirit, who comes in wind and fire, give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you and all those whom you love. Now and always. Amen.
Go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Thanks.